Hello. Every time I jump off, I fall stuck somewhere with a DNF.
Hey everyone, I'm at the camera's there. Today I'm at the Wentworthville Community Centre, the Redlands Function Centre for Clock, and I'm trialling a new technique I've developed for Clock called the Circular Location Orientation Calculation Kinetic Method. Charlie Eggins is here doing Blindfold and a bunch of other events. Good to see him again. He's off to Nationals and he'll also be going to a Worlds event later this year in South Korea. I'll be staying for a little bit more just to do some judging. And
I've got my lunch here, which is a fish curry and some garlic naan.
11 minutes later.
I'd prefer to have a speaker.
God, OCR champion. You were OCR champion. I realised you. I was going to ask you about that. You've been bumped off like several times. I talked to you at Oceanic last year, I think, when you got it.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome. And in this intermediate level tutorial, I'm going to assume you understand the basic functioning of the clock, how the pins work, how to move the dials, how one side relates to the other side. Here's the first scramble that we're going to solve, and we want to have the 12 at the top, and we're going to start looking with the left-handmost clock face. And what we want to see for an optimization is, do any of them align with the center face? And in this particular side, nothing matches, but if we turn over to this side, 12 at the top, we can see the left and the right clock match the middle clock. And so for us, that's a zero position. And so that's a great optimization. Having two is a very lucky scramble. So what we want to do is work out how far it is from the center to the outside, and we negate the result based on the clock notation. So from here to here, it's zero, because no movement's required to go from this clock face to this clock face. From here to here, we go one, two, three. So we move one, two, three, get down to this clock face. Because we're going to be doing it reversed, we want to negate the values. So it's actually minus one, minus two, minus three. So we have zero, minus three, zero again. And then to get to this one, one, two, three, four, five. So it's minus five. So the four numbers we need to remember are zero, minus three, zero, minus five. Remember, our numbers are 0, minus 3, 0, minus 5.
Okay, my biggest fear is the DNF, yeah.
0, minus 3, 0, minus 5. That's all you need to remember. Turn it over, put it down. When we start, we push these two left-hand pins down and these two right-hand pins up. First one 0, so it doesn't need to move. So we can use our right hand to go two spaces to join that one. We then rotate, push that pin down and the bottom right pin up. So we're in the same, right hand pins up, left hand pins down. The second number is minus 3. Since we're here, minus 3 is to here. 1, 2, 3. We want to move this one to match the middle clock, to match the left hand clock. Rotate again. Push the top left hand pin down, bottom right hand pin up, and again this one's zero, so it doesn't move, and it's just one move to bring that clock into alignment with the center clock. The center clock in alignment with the left hand clock. Rotate again, use our thumb to push down the top left, pop up the bottom right, and this time it's minus five, so we're here, so minus five is going to be down to here, and then we push the center and the other pins, which you can see now, are aligned to here. Using this hand, we push up the bottom left pin and roll everything to face up. That side's now done. Turn it over with an action of, now you've got top north, the 12 is there. So turn it over with a bit of a twist, and we can see all the clock faces are now aligned. And we've got a lucky one here, that one's already aligned. So we push up these two pins, so we've got three up and that one's down. Roll down to there. We can see this one here and this one here. I tend to go in order. So we push the top left up, bottom right down. Bring all the clock faces to match that one. Bottom left up, bottom right down. Push them to match that. Push them all up, roll to the top, and we're done. Let's do the first scramble again, but we'll look at both sides at the same time as we're doing the solve. So going from this side where we have the zeros, 0, minus 3, 0, minus 5. 0 from here to here, 1, 2, 3 to get to here, it's minus 3, 0, minus 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 5. So leaving this side by itself, when we push these two right-hand pins up and these two down, the first number is going to be, remember, zero, so we do nothing. Rotate, push the right-hand pins up, left-hand pins down, and if you remember, the first number is going to be 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, minus three. So we're going to go minus direction on this side, and we can see here, this is now lined up with this. Rotate again, this is a zero, so we don't need to change that. Rotate again, and it's going to be minus five. So we see this one's here, we're going to bring it up to here, and we want to go minus five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But we'll turn that over, bring it over to this side, and I'll show you it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now they're all lined up. So what we're doing on this side is effectively the opposite of what we're doing on this side. On this side, we're rolling these ones around to match this. And on this side, because these pins are up, we're rolling this side around to match this. When we're finished, we roll everything up to 12. And then we can start working on the other side just to finish the clock faces. This would be solved as well.
Moments later.
This is the last scramble, and we can see here that this clock face and this clock face are the same. That's a 6 to this one, plus or minus 6, it doesn't matter, it's the opposite direction. So this is from here to here is a 3, from here to here is minus 2, 0 is 6. So this one would be 1, 2, 3, positive 3, minus 2, 1, 2, minus 2. 0, 6. If we look at the other side, we have from here to here, 1, 2, minus 2, remember, because clockwise is negative, anti-clockwise is positive. So we have minus 2, and plus 2, and plus 2, and then 0. I prefer this side because the numbers here are the same. Both sides have a 0, but these numbers are the same, so it makes it a little bit easier to remember. Minus 2, 2, 2, 0. Minus 2, 2, 2, 0. So we turn it over. Let's take a quick break and ask Edward Hollingdale what he thinks of clock.
This event sucks. I just want to make that clear.
Thanks, Edward.
8 seconds. 12 seconds.
No,
I don't. And we pick it up. We've got the first number. Top left, bottom left go down. And then the right ones are up. And the first number was minus 2. And then we roll this one center to match the left-hand side. Rotate, top left down, bottom right up. And it's 1, 2. And then we roll center around to match this one, which was the 6 from before. Same again, top left down, bottom right up. And this one again is 1, 2. And these are 0, so they don't need to move. Rotate again, top left down, bottom right up. And this one's 0 on this side. So these two can come here. Push the bottom left up so we have 3 up. And then roll them so that all the center ones are face up. Rotate and quarter twist. And we can now see all the clock faces here are the same. Push up two pins. I'm gonna make this one match this one. And we'll just go around. Push down the one you want to change, keep all the other ones up, and then again, And the last one, this one here. And then roll them all up and we're finished. Let me know in the comments below what you think of this and how you go and what your times are. At home, I regularly get around about 10, 11 seconds. And as always in competition, I do worse. After you've watched this video, you can then watch another video here of my previous clock attempt last year in 2022 when I first used this technique. And you can also subscribe down here. So thanks for watching and we'll catch you next time.